We're going to go over how to evaluate variable expressions that have exponents. So what I mean is if we're going to plug in a number for a variable, but there might be an exponent on the variable. For instance, let's evaluate two expressions by plugging in negative 3 for x. So the first one, 2x cubed. There are two ways to do this. The first way is to start by writing the meaning of 2x cubed, which would be 2 times x times x times x. I actually think when people do it this way, they make less mistakes. So now we're going to plug in negative 3 for x. So I've got negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times the 2 at the beginning. The answer is going to be negative because we have 3 negative signs. And then multiplying all that together, you should get negative 54. Okay, an alternative way of doing this is by directly replacing the x with negative 3. Now here you have to be extremely careful that you put the negative 3 in parentheses so it's clear that x and negative 3, the base, is going to the third power. Then you could simplify negative 3 to the third power by writing it out as negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3, so it looks just like it does up here, or if you do that on scratch paper, you'd have 2 times negative 27, and you would still get an answer of negative 54. I actually think it's easier to do it the first way. Okay, now let's do the second one, negative 4x squared. So we have a negative 4 times x times x, doing it the first way. And then I plug in negative 3, so I have times negative 3 times negative 3. Again, we happen to have 3 negative signs, so our answer will be negative. And multiplying together, we get negative 36. The other way to do that same problem is by directly substituting in a negative 3, but you absolutely must put x in parentheses. When you're replacing the base with a negative number, make sure you put the base, x in this case, which is negative 3, in parentheses. You must do that if you're not going to write it out as x times x first. And then you can now write out negative 4 times negative 3 times negative 3, so it ends up looking like that, or you could do that in your head, which is 9, because it means negative 3 times negative 3, and still get a negative 36. Here's another example. Evaluate when x equals negative 2 and y equals negative 5. Again, I think it's easier to write out the meaning before you replace the variables with the numerical values. So if we did that first, we would have 3 times x plus 2. Now, this is really x to the first, but this is a y times a y. And then we have 4 times y times y. If you do this first, usually you make less mistakes. Now you replace the variables with the correct numbers. So we have 3 times negative 2 times negative 2 plus 2 times negative 2 times negative 5 times negative 5 minus 4 times negative 5 times negative 5. Okay, so what do we have here? We have the negative 2 times negative 2 is 4, so 3 times 4 is 12. Here we're going to have 3 negatives. I could put plus a negative, or I could just write minus in front of it and then multiply out here. So this is going to be 100. 2 times 2 times 5 times 5. You could do that several different ways. That's going to be 100. What do I have over here? I have a minus sign, another minus sign, another minus sign. That's going to also be a negative. So keep in mind, you could write this as plus a negative 100 or just write minus 100. Same for this problem here. This also happens to be 100. Okay. All right, so remember, this is plus a negative 100, plus a negative 100. So basically, that's going to be 12 minus 200 if you want to do it that way. And I'm going to have a minus sign, and then I have to do 200 minus 12, which is, let's see, 188. So this is negative 188. Okay. Let's do it by directly replacing the variables with the numerical values in the first step. All right, so same exact problem. We're going to just simply plug in negative 2 for x, but you must put it in parentheses. Okay? Anytime you have a variable to an exponent, if the base, that variable, is negative, you must put it in parentheses. So I need to do this. Now this is just x. I'm going to put it in parentheses, but you could put times negative 2 a different way. But the y must be in parentheses because it's raised to the second power. And going across, we have minus 4, y again must go in parentheses. All right, so what do we have here? So at this point, you could write down negative 2 times negative 2. It would look like the previous part, or you could do that in your head. That's positive 4, negative 2 times negative 2. And what's over here? I can do this in two steps. I have 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. And a negative 5 times negative 5 is a negative 25. I'm sorry, positive 25. And this one also is negative 5 times negative 5, which is 25. Do not make the mistake of doing 4 times 5 first. The order of operations says you have to do the exponents first if you're going to write it out this way. You won't have this problem if you did it the way I did it in the first method. Okay, so let's just keep going. We're almost there. 12 plus negative 100. This is minus 100, which is also negative 100. And you can go left or right, however you want to do this. You can have negative 88 plus negative 100, negative 188, you know, depending on how you do your subtraction. And let's just scroll up. Remember how we did it the other way? We also got negative 188. Notice if you change all of your very first step, if you go ahead and change this to x times x, you won't have to worry about the order of operations if you're going to do exponents first or you're going to do multiplication, because you've changed everything to multiplication. Correct? So then you just do the multiplication first and then you do the addition next. And that's why I think this first method is a lot easier for many people. One last thing to note is in this first problem here, the middle term 2xy squared, notice that the x is to the first power. Only the y is being squared. So when I multiply this out, I have 2 times x times y times y. Another common mistake is thinking of that as xy and then squaring it. So just watch out for that mistake, and I think you won't have any trouble at all. So have a good time. Have fun.